Welcome to Diamond. In this video, we'll show you how to create your own reports. To do so, you work with the Results Analyzer bar. The Analyzer bar is under the tab View. Add the ribbon Analysis. Here you see the icon. When you press it, the Analyzer bar is being activated. The Analyzer bar is now at the bottom of my screen, and when I go over with the mouse, I click and I just pull it up. Also, the Analyzer bar has the basic functionalities of all the other screens which can open and be closed. So first to remember, it's interactive. So when we unleash it here, so the ribbon now is on the left side of my screen. And when I click on it, the Analyzer bar comes up and it goes away again when I start working on something else. Also, I can fixate the screen here by pushing this icon here. Now it's fixed in my screen. It will not go away anymore and I can use this quite stable. And when I double click or click on the ribbon and pull it away, I unleash it and I can easily maneuver this functionality to another screen. And by double click ribbon again, it's locked inside and the Analyzer bar is again on its place. Or I can use here this icon to move it away. But also you see here this triangle. This triangle is to show this navigation or not. So when this triangle is pointed to the right side of my screen, I don't see the navigation bar. So when I want to have it popped up, the pointer is to the left side of the screen. I have to click it and it comes up again. So if you cannot find the screen, just check if the pointer is going to the right or to the left. And then you know where it is by clicking it. And to fully close the Analyzer bar, I just press the cross here and it's gone again and totally deactivated. If I want to activate it again, I have to go to this icon, press it and it's there. Now let's go over the functionalities of the Results Analyzer bar. I have here a few tabs, the Data View, Report Options, Common Options and the Advice Management Tool. The Report Options I use to select and create the table on itself. I can select here more functionalities, I show you later in the video. Then we have the Data View. Once I've selected the table, I can present it here with a preview on my screen before I exported it to Excel, PDF or Word. Then I view the common options, which I can select how the font should look like and how the table should be presented on my paper. And I view the advice management tool. This functionality can import a shablon which you created in Microsoft Office Word for a full integrated visibility study. Also, this functionality will be explained later in another video. Now, the first step we want to do is just create a simple report. For this, what we first do is to activate the Reports option tab here. And then I just select a time period. So I have here the years. I'll take the year 2020 till the year 2022. I just select my forecast, for example. Then I click here on the white space and the ribbon will go to the left directly. Click. I will open the folder balance sheet. I select balance sheet type B, for example, and also profit loss account. Select the one with the EBITDA. And from my cash flow liquidity statement, I want to have a financial overview. I go into the cross and now they are all here selected. There's now one thing left to do and just to press the button preview. Now the reports are being created and being presented on your screen. Quite nice and efficient. So if you want to have it bigger, I can go here to the, for example, to the 200%. It's now quite readable on my screen. And with this functionality here, I go to the pages. So the next step which I have to do now is to export what I have on my screen to Excel, Word or PDF. But just pressing the small triangle here on the Dropbox, this pops up. And now I show you how it exported to Excel. I just press Excel. Now the Excel is being presented on the folder for my Diamond FMS outputs. I give it a name. Let's call it test one. I save it. And they say, do you want to share it and save it? Yes. So under the tabs sheet 1, 2 and 3, the tables are being presented. It's being saved on my computer so I can work with it. I close it now. When I want to create an export to Microsoft Office Word, I press again this Dropbox, export, select Word, and automatically there's a document name. I can change it, call it test2. It's also being saved directly in my folder DiamondFMS outputs on my computer. I press save. And the system asks me, would you like to open it? I say yes, let's open it. Now you see that my tables are quite nicely presented here in my Microsoft Word Office document. And I can now add the text and explanations as I want. And the last functionality is to export it directly to a PDF. For exporting it to a PDF, again go to the Dropbox export. Click on it, select PDF. And now a PDF file is being created. I can change the name, call it test3. And you see the PDF is also saved automatically on my computer in the folder outputs. I save it. The system asks me to open it. And now my PDF is on my screen. And I can close it again if I want. So, thank you for watching this video in the first introduction how to create reports. In future videos, we go much deeper into this bright, strong functionality. See you next time. Bye bye.